Just lie down for 12 minutes and do it till the last moment, till you fall asleep. This is something you must notice. If a little space arises, suddenly this is the end of suffering in your life. Believe me, something remarkable will happen. There are two aspects to everything that I do. One is there is a spiritual dimension which can be transmitted in many different ways. There is a mystical dimension. Mysticism has no purpose. Mysticism is just pure exploration. It has no purpose. But this is the nature of human intelligence. Even if there's no purpose, this intelligence wants to know. This is the nature of human intelligence. If you release people from their daily concerns and fears, believe me, every human being will want to know everything in the universe. Right now, their day-to-day nonsense is keeping them busy. Their psychological and physiological drama is keeping them busy, busy, busy all the time. If they had no concerns, everybody would pay attention to everything and want to know everything. Mysticism has no utility. It is simply like pure science, you just want to know. Well, your life becomes profound, but it has no application as such. How can I go out on the street and use my mysticism? There is no such thing. Spiritual process has a certain use to your own emancipation, your own liberation, your own freedom that you achieve within yourself. In that sense, if you must take away, because we are in America, you must take away something. When you die, what will you take away? I want to know. Hello? This body is not really you. Do you know? If you live for about 60 years, you're on an average, most human beings are eating anywhere between 1100 to 1400 tons of food. So that means even what you think is my body is not this, it's changing every day. New input is happening and old things are going away. So 1400 tons, you don't have to carry that much of weight right now. So obviously, what you have as a body right now is just a transient amount of food and soil, isn't it? Hello? So what you think is mine also is not it, it is just all the time changing. So at least try this much. Tonight before you go to bed, spend at least 12-15 minutes reminding yourself, you're neither this body nor this mind. Just lie down and just remind yourself, what is my body is not me. What I think is my mind is not me. It is mine right now for use, but it's not really me. Just, if you're not able to do it, just link it to your breath. Inhalation, I'm not the body. Exhalation, I'm not even the mind. Just lie down for 12 minutes and do it till the last moment, till you fall asleep. This is something you must notice. Most human beings, when I say most, I'm very generous with the percentage, 99%. 99% of the human beings never notice that moment when they're slipping from wakefulness to sleep. They will simply go off like that. If they're alert, they cannot sleep. But there is a way to sleep in an alert manner. If you sleep like that, one thing that will happen to you is your sleep quota, if you're sleeping for 8 hours, it'll simply drop to 3 to 4 hours just straight away. Now that moment when you're passing from wakefulness to sleep, if you can still be conscious that I'm not the body and I'm not the mind, believe me, something remarkable will happen. There is a difference between being and doing. Doing is related to our body or our thought process or our emotion, or maybe even the energetically you can do certain things. But being is not connected to any of these things, because all these things you accumulate from outside. So a dimension which is not physical in nature, you don't do anything with it, there's nothing to do with it. It is just that if you, in your awareness, in your consciousness, if what is you and what is not you, there is a little space between you and your body, between you and your mind, if a little space arises, suddenly this is the end of suffering in your life. Because you know only two kinds of suffering, physical suffering and mental suffering. Do you know any other kind of suffering? Hello? Even if you're an expert in the field, still you don't know any other kind of suffering, isn't it? Physical and mental. Once there's a little space between you and the body and you and the mind, this is the end of suffering. Only when there is no fear of suffering will you naturally want to walk full stride, wanting to know every dimension of life. When there is fear of suffering, you walk half steps. You only want to do what is safe. And there is nothing safe in this world except dying. Life, anything can happen.